just stuck in a hole, and I want you to get out. I don't know what there is to see, but I know it's time for you to leave. We're all just pushing along, trying to figure it out. Change, so clear your head and come round. You only have to open your eyes, you might just get a big surprise, and it may feel good, and you might want to smile, smile, smile. Oh, don't you let your demons pull you down, 'cause you can have it all, you can have it all. Oh, oh. So come on, so come on, get it.
Take that and shine on 102.5 Club. When it's 19 minutes to 9, Mark Owen's just walked in.
What is that? I've been handed a pot of tea. Right. I'm making myself here.
Are these your own tea bags?
Nobody around here is helping. I've brought my own lemon and ginger teas this morning.
Lemon and ginger.
I've got a coffee as well. I've got lots of fluids on the go.
So you're doing coffee and tea at the same time?
I am.
Are you a morning person, Mark?
Well, I have three children.
Well, there you go.
So you have no choice.
Yeah. I've done this breakfast show for 17 years. I'm still not a morning person. You know that way I just cannot get up in the morning. It's just like, see you at the weekends, forget it. So nice of you to come in live, because a lot of people now just do it down by a satellite. They sit in an office in London and just talk to
us. I did it that way last time, I think, didn't I? But do you know what I really enjoyed? Yesterday I came up from the train and it was so nice to kind of see a bit of the... You know, the country and stuff.
Yeah, exactly. I've already had people getting in touch saying thanks to Mark for doing photos with us at Central Station. I take it there's a lot of that. That must be
met
tough.
A few people.
That must be hell, because like everywhere you go, everyone's got a camera now.
Mm.
And it must
in
just
today's
be like,
world, you mean? Yeah, that is very true. But everybody's got the phones, aren't they?
But I'm as bad
as everybody else. I get my phone. I'm like, oh, let me just take a picture.
Is that right?
It's the same as everybody else. Can I just get a picture of you while I'm here?
On you go. Go for it. Do you want me to hold my belly in and smile?
No, you just be you.
Right. Me being me holding in my belly.
There you go. Oh, see, everybody's happy.
This is it. I'm going on Instagram, everybody. So,
be on my Twitter page, that in a minute.
Brilliant. Back with a new single, Stars, which you'll play shortly.
Great.
How does it feel to be doing your own thing again? Because it must be weird to go from being solo to be back with a band to back doing the own thing.
Yes. Yes and no, really. I mean, there's some of it can be a bit strange, you know, because you've been doing many years where you're part of this team, and everywhere you go, it's kind of there's a load of you know. Mm.
You've all got to agree on what you do.
Yeah, but and when you're doing it on your own, yeah, it's slightly a bit different, but it's not massively different. I'm still doing songs, and so the at the base of it is the same. It's just you keep looking around now and again going, oh, where's everybody gone?
Yeah. Do you get advice from the other guys? Will you phone them up and say, I'm working on a track, what do you think would work with this? Or
No, I haven't done on this record. I could do, I guess, if I wanted to, but they've all heard it and sent nice messages and stuff.
Oh, that's cool.
And actually, it was just didn't work out. They've all been quite busy, and I wanted to keep this quiet at the bottom of my garden and just keep it amongst a few people and see how it went. So it didn't really feel like the type of record that I wanted to, you know, needed to phone everybody, really. It was quite nice just working it out for yourself. Sometimes it's quite nice working it out for yourself.
Yeah, and just doing it, and just taking your time.
Yeah.
And going, I'm just going to take my time here, I'm going to get this right. Now, the video is a bit weird. If you haven't seen the video, by the way, it's on YouTube, is that right?
Yes,
is it up
it
there
is,
just
yeah.
now? It looks like every boy's dream, because you're jumping about with fire and dinosaurs. Tell us a bit about that.
Yeah, I guess so. I think but my main, because the song's called Stars, initially I was hoping that we could fly up to space and I could do my video up there, but the label didn't have the budget for doing that. Unfortunately,
cheapskates in that corner.
They said, you're not having money for that, you're going up to Radio Clyde, so we'll do that instead. But they did give me a spaceman suit.
All right, well,
which is very kind of them, and I managed to wear it around Berlin for a day, so I was very grateful.
That's what you need. Are you going to wear it when you play the ABC?
No, I only had it for the day. It was only on hire, so try and find one.
Because you're going on tour. This is just like a little mini tour. Is that right for the new album?
Yeah, we're going to do 8 or so dates, I think, around the UK, which will be fun.
Okay, and there is a Glasgow date at the ABC. Do we know what that date is, the ABC? We'll find out.
I think it might be, I
will find out. I will get back to you on this one. Oh, there you go. It's Sunday the 16th. That's 16th. Where it's going to be.
There you go.
So you want to get tickets for Mark. He's going to be at the ABC on Sunday the 16th. Listen, we're going to play a new song now. We'll come back and we'll talk some more with Owen, who's getting stuck into the tea and the coffee and the jam
Everything one could require.
Anytime you want it, paint it pretty colours. Gonna light it up and take us to the moon. That's what I'm gonna do. That's what I'm gonna save up all the paper. Gonna need later. Maybe take a minute to get in my head. Directions all the way. You want to get away. I'm taking you. I say that I'm leaving, just got to hang on.
Is Mark Owen's new song. Mark's with me this morning. The new album's called The Art of Doing Nothing. It's out on the 10th of June. Now, is that about your kids, that song? Is that right?
No, well, I guess in some ways, no. I think I just kind of dedicated it to them, to be honest. No, the first time, when I first wrote that song, I thought, oh, this feels good. And I went into the house and put it on the stereo in the house, put it on a CD and ran in. And when I put it on, I said, oh, listen to this. Yeah, I think this is a good one. And they did a little dance together.
Oh, that's
so
cool.
It was a moment. That's probably where you've got
that. That's quite cute. Yeah. Do your kids, your older kids understand? You know, that dad's this big star in a band and big musician.
I don't think they think too much about it. I think what they understand that dad does music at the bottom of the garden, and they understand that if they come down and press all the buttons that are in dad's studio, it usually makes dad pull his hair out.
Yeah, you're going to get angry. Would you like your kids to do that as a career? Because
you were just saying about your son, yeah.
Yeah, he's played the ABC a couple of weeks ago,
which is very exciting.
And it's kind of weird because I'm not really into rock music. I'm more into dance music and get into the club thing. I was saying to you that I've DJed with Howard a couple of times. And it's nice to kind of watch your children not follow in your footsteps, but do something similar to you.
In a similar world, yeah.
Yeah,
I wouldn't be against it at all. I think my daughter Willow, she likes singing and stuff. She always sits at the piano and tinkles on there. So she might...
Oh, that's cool.
May do, but I don't know. It's up to them what they want to do with it. But it's funny because my dad was in a band, so in a way, I guess I've kind of followed a little bit in the...
I didn't realise that. So your dad was a musician as well?
In a lot of Irish country kind of folk bands.
Right.
Yeah, he still does it now. He still goes out on a Friday. He says, oh, I've got a gig this weekend, son.
Is that right?
Yeah.
Have you ever gone along to one of the gigs? Because I think
I used to come out when I was... young, when I was very young, we used to go every Friday and Saturday. It was ace because we could just run riot around these venues while my dad was playing in a band. So
that would be awesome. Yeah, I love that. Now you're gonna have your kids running around stadiums going crazy while dad's playing.
Yeah, they've been to a few of the shows that we've done in the past. I think as long as they come with headphones, they're quite happy.
That's okay. Yeah. With Peppa Pig in the back or Justin Fletcher's CD in the background. Mr. Tumble.
102.5 Clyde One Traffic and Travel.
With Apollo Blinds, the most beautiful and elegant window blinds and shutters for the last 40 years.
Right, I tell you what we're going to do in just a sec. We're going to try and phone back one of Mark's fans who have been texting in this morning. Just pick someone at random and make their morning, which would be rather cool. But first, Siobhan's going to sort out some travel.
Thanks, George. M80 eastbound, it's still slow moving at 28 Glasgow Airport, going through to 25 Cardonald. Busy again eastbound at 22 Plantation and 21 Seaward Street, going up onto the Kingston Bridge. And the M77 northbound is back at Junction 3, Knitts Hill Road. Westbound M8, it's slowing down at 12 Cumbernauld Road and 13 Proven. That's clearing up once you past Junction 16 at Craig Hall. Still affecting the M80 southbound, it's busy at Junction 2, Rob Royston, and on the A8, slow moving both ways at Shawhead. I'm Siobhan. Any problems on your journey, let me know. 0141 565 2274.
Got Amy Winehouse playing in 60 seconds.
Hello, welcome to Halfords. How can I help you?
I want to ride my bicycle.
Sorry, come again?
I want to ride my bike.
Oh, you can't, your chain's broken.
I want to ride my bicycle.
And you have a puncture.
I want to ride it where I like.
Sure, you can ride these bikes pretty much anywhere. Here you go, good as new. Halfords We Repair. Our mechanics can fix chains and punctures while you wait and service your bike within 48 hours, dependent on parts availability.
Across Glasgow and the West.
102.5 Clyde One.
If you have or are thinking about taking out a payday loan, then what about a DAS? I'm Peter Dean, your debt expert. A DAS is not a loan, it's a Scottish Government scheme that could solve your cash flow problems by reducing your monthly payments, freezing interest and stopping those demanding phone calls and letters. To apply for a DAS, just Google me, Peter Dean, debt expert, or go to yourdebtexpert.com. So don't think loan, think DAS. Don't delay, apply at yourdebtexpert.com or call 0808 2020 225. Subject to acceptance, conditions apply.
Darkness that we know and this regret I got accustomed to. Once it was the ride when we were at our height.
in the hotel at night. I knew I had him at my match, but every moment we get snatched. I don't know why I got so attached. It's my responsibility, you don't own nothing to me but to walk away. I have no capacity. He walks away, the sun goes down. He takes the day, but I'm grown. And in your way, in this blue shade, my tears dry on their own. I don't understand, why do I stress the man when there's so many bigger things at hand? We could have never had it all, we had to hit a wall. So this is inevitable withdrawal. Even if I stop wanting you, that perspective pushes through. I'll be some next man's other woman, so I can't upgrade myself again. Should just be my own best friend. I put myself in the head with stupid man. He walks away, the sun goes. Ain't no regrets and no emotion, no day. Cause as we kiss goodbye, the sun sets. So we are history. The shadow covers me. The sky above the blaze. Lonely lovers see. He walks away. The sun goes.
Try on their own. Amy Winehouse at 102.5 Club. Do you want to phone one of your fans back, Mark? We'll
do this. Oh, yeah, that'd be a good idea. Let's do that while we're here. Why not?
Hello?
Hello, Louisa.
Hello.
Hello.
Who's this?
How are you doing?
Who's this?
This is George Bowie, King of Breakfast Radio.
Oh, my God.
I've got someone here that wants to say hello to you. Say hello, Louisa Mark.
Hello, Louisa. It's Mark Owen here. I'm here with the King of Breakfast Radio.
You see,
oh my goodness.
How are you? Are you okay?
I'm fine. How are you?
I'm very good. Very, very pleased to be up here in Glasgow, up in Scotland. Very exciting.
Oh, we're glad to have you.
Oh, and the sun's shining.
It is, but it was raining earlier. So
it was raining earlier, but we've got a bit of sunshine now, which is nice.
Now, Louisa, you've spent thousands going to see Tick That Live, is that right?
I have.
I have too.
And Yeah. But you can claim it back through the record company, you know what I mean? It's a guy sitting over there with just an open check. But you've strategically placed the birth of your children around Tick That tour dates. Is this correct?
Well, yes.
Is that how have you managed that? And what does your partner say about that?
My husband has no choice in the matter. No. He just gets called up to
me. That's brilliant. I like that.
Does he go to the gigs with you or?
No, he does not.
Because a lot of husbands are really enjoying it now. It's amazing the amount of guys that enjoy going to Tick That concert now. I think when you first started out, Mark, they'd be right in saying it would be like 99% girls, but a lot of guys going out too.
Yeah, I think the band the second time round is a different band, really, compared to what it was the first time. The first time it was mainly a female audience and mainly us taking our clothes off, but you know, we leave our clothes on nowadays.
Probably for the best. Louisa, we've got a crack on. Is there anything you want to say to Mark before we go?
I'm really sorry I can't make the tour, but I'm due to give birth the week that you're actually playing in Glasgow.
Oh, really? How many will that be then?
Pardon?
How many children will you have then?
This is my first.
Your first one? Oh.
Yeah.
Okay. Oh, well, congratulations, then, and good luck with all
please
that.
Please come back again later in the year so that I can come to see you playing your new album.
Oh, that's very kind of you. We will. If all goes well, we'll be back up here before the end of the year.
Oh, brilliant.
Bless you. Thank you very much, and good luck with that. Do you know what you're having?
I don't.
You don't. You're going to wait for the surprise.
I am.
Well, good luck.
Best of luck, Louisa. See you later.
Thank
bye.
You. Cheers. Bye.
Oh, just made somebody's life there. There we go. Fantastic.
Oh, she was a nice lady.
She's
very
great.
Nice.
Listen, Mark, thank you so much for coming up. Lovely to see you.
It's a pleasure.
I know we've spoken before, but it's always been done satellite, so it's nice to meet you in the flesh.
Really nice to see you.
And I'll look forward to coming along to the ABC for the gig engine.
So yes. I look forward to it.
Best of luck
bring your
novel.
Son. Tell your son good luck with his band.
I will do, and I'll bring him along to see you. Thanks, Mark. Yep. All the best, pal.
All right, mate.
We are getting buried to break.